Hail, hail, the gang is all here. Live at 9 is bringing back some of your favorite news personalities as we celebrate 60 years of WREG.
And here they are, my former co-anchors on News Channel 3 Daybreak for more than a decade, Joe Larkins, Joey Hadley, and we had to bring Mr. Todd, starts with T and runs
right.
with trouble. No,
that's not it. Just happy to be sitting next to Mr. Jammed Up and Jelly Tight.
I know.
Remember that?
I do remember that. And that's awesome. If you leave on time, you're going to arrive on time. You're
making it on time. Pole job on the running traffic.
Yeah, I don't know if we'd make it in today's PC world.
No, that's I'm surprised that the FCC allows this much
testosterone.
I mean, it's just like I actually turned mine down to about 85%.
Oh, okay. Well,
just before I walked in.
We were just getting it under the cap, as they would say.
Well, and I've had to already throw a bucket of cold water on Mary Beth. She's just like, well, Mary Beth, or is that a hot flash?
These days it's a hot flash. But in the old days, you know, it was because, you know, here, you sit next to this, what do you expect? Okay, so I intended to go to a fireplace store this weekend, and naturally I forgot because, you know, it's the age, and get some bellows. Would you remember why I might have wanted to give you those to tell a Daybreak story?
And it was during the freeze of 1994, I believe,
the ice storm.
And power went off, and I got up because I knew that as soon as I heard the sounds of silence, had to go in because it was going to be just we were going to need to all be there. I was in the middle of a shower in the dark, and I realized, how am I going to dry my hair? And because, I mean, it was so cold, if I went outside, my hair would be frozen. So my wife went to the fireplace and brought out the bellows. And I sat there, and she...
Only television anchor
she,
ever.
She was pumping the bellows, and I came in and just looking, well, looking like this.
You look great.
I love it. You always had some TV hair. Now, and Joey, you, of course, the first, if I'm not correct, not mistaken, traffic reporter for Channel 3, is that right?
Right.
You know, you could educate...
the first in the city.
First in the city.
What, one of the first in the city,
so
weren't you?
So you did have some patented phrases.
Oh, man, I loved them.
Jammed up and jelly
jammed
tight.
Jammed up, jelly
one.
Tight. I used to get coffee in the morning when I was back there. Something would just hit me.
You just stand with the coffee
a good
mug.
Rhyme, a good rhyme.
Usually as the producer, because you weren't where you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be there. Get in there.
And he was very famous for his clothing as well. I see that has not changed. I still have some of the old shirts from the old days.
When we were standing out outside before they would, you know, clear us security-wise to come in here, he had his jacket on and had it all buttoned up tight, and it's just like, man, is he going to come out in flashes or something? And then he did the slow reveal.
And you, of course, were a Shelby County Sheriff's Deputy at the time you retired. Then you're now running a gym, right?
Well, I work for Memphis Judo and Jiu-Jitsu. It's a mixed martial arts gym. It's owned by David Ferguson.
So you can take Joe down right now? Like put him in a headlock?
he can probably. Drop me like a bad habit. As he
Well, many people need to remember that Joey's history includes a great deal of boxing success in his early years.
Golden
as well.
Gloves?
Yeah.
When I was younger, yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
That explains why he accepted a TV job. He'd gotten hit in the head 2-1.
And that's why most people who know him call him Sir.
Okay, so see if this doesn't take you back. I think Todd knows what we're about to show, but it was probably the only moment on Memphis TV when you actually heard anchors speaking Japanese.
Konnichiwa. Nagano Olympico kanishi te kiono daybreak wa nihongo de okureshimasu.
Mid-South no chusin kara. Nihon Nagano Mayday WeatherNet 3. Ga kuru suru saishin no tangi joho desu.
Oshigo koini, gakoni, okora nayo, kono kotsu joho o ayukatata ka desai.
News ga aruto korani wa watashi tachi ga masu News Channel 3 Daybreak.
Hi.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome.
I worked pretty hard to get that translated.
If you saw the cameras, Todd, you were just mouthing around with that too. You remember
more
it.
Time.
What happened to our hair, guys? I mean, it looks
I'd still rather it turn gray than turn loose.
Okay. That's right.
We
that's
spent right. more time working on that 30-second promo in honor of the Olympics than we
that
did ever on the newscast.
1998.
Is it Nagano?
Yeah, Nagano.
Wow.
I wonder if there's any...
Hi.
Look at the TV, look at the screen real quick. There you go. We did a little comparison before and after shot there.
What a baby.
Take a look at that.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
So what are you doing now? Inform the people.
Well, I left Channel 3. I started a video production company, which sounds like a bigger deal than what it is. It's Lead Dog Video.
Appropriate, because, of course, you were known for your dog stories.
And there's a Scottish Terrier is the logo, and the slogan is, if you're not with a lead dog, the view is always the same. Kind of a variation. Mm-hmm. And in addition to that, I am also a corporate pilot.
Are you?
Yes, you get that license, well, and you didn't tell me.
I started doing this past summer, and when I'm not doing video work,
I can call you up and say,
where are you taking
quick
us?
Flight? Where are we going?
Where are you taking us? I think there's a Super Bowl we want to go to.
Not just entrust their lives to you, they pay you to do this?
Yeah, can you imagine?
No,
that?
I can't. Yes, I can.
But as my 10-year-old granddaughter, I have two grandchildren now, a 10-year-old and a 4-year-old, and she has told me the secret to always being successful as a pilot. Make sure the landings and takeoffs always equal and land with a shiny side up.
Mm-hmm. Which is kind of a rule for TV.
If you follow those guidelines, then everything's good.
And Joey was into dogs as well. I've always known you to have Dalmatians. What is it about you and Dalmatians?
I got my first one. I was about 18 years old, and they're great dogs if you can put up with them for about the first 2 years.
Because they're kind of hyper, right?
Very, very hyper. But after a couple of years, they are the best dogs, and I've got one now. She's almost 3.
They match your shirt. There you go. Oh, and we could sit here all day and tell some stories on these two. Believe me,
we don't have all day.
Yeah.
What does this mean? Because I see them out there.
We've got a helicopter waiting for you outside.
You know, I've never figured that out either.
You never paid attention to it when I was working.
Here, Jen.
Okay. You're getting irritated. Thank you so much for making time for us. Y'all are awesome. I swear.
Well, coming up.